Parashat Vayeira, the binding of Isaac. The question is often asked, who was really being tested? Was the greater test upon Abraham to sacrifice his beloved son to God? Or was the greatest test for Isaac, who was the one who, after all, was being asked to give up his life? As a father, and as a father who has seen his children and grandchildren in the army, I don't think there is a parent in the world who wouldn't gladly give up his own life rather than, God forbid, see his child hurt and having to make the ultimate sacrifice. From that perspective, I certainly understand very well that the major test came to Abraham. But I'd like to look at this entire incident from a bit of a different perspective. At the end of the day, Abraham believed strongly that he heard God's command. And Maimonides, in his Guide for the Perplexed, even derives from the entire story of the binding of Isaac the fact that the prophet believed indubitably, completely, in the prophecy which he heard from God. Obviously, if there had been any question whatsoever in Abraham's mind as to the source of the command, he never would have sacrificed, he never would have gone to sacrifice his son. So Abraham heard from God, was certain that he had heard from God. And I dare say if any of us would receive such a command directly from God, we would find the strength to carry it out. Isaac didn't hear it from God. Isaac only heard it from his father. Vayelchu shnehem yachdav, and the two of them walked together, says the Bible, because Isaac, although he only heard it from his father, accepted it completely and was ready to give up his life. From that perspective, I believe that the test for Isaac was much greater than the test for Abraham. And I would like, just for a very few moments, to flesh out this idea. Abraham and Isaac, to a certain extent, are studies in contrast. Abraham was a very optimistic pathbreaker, iconoclast, started a new faith, waged successful wars, managed to accrue much property and cattle, and became, in effect, a world leader. Isaac was much more passive. Everything happens to him. A wife is found for him, he is taken to the binding, even the blessings are wrested from him. Isaac is not the path breaker. Isaac is the continuer. But from that perspective, Isaac is most Jews. Most people are not path breakers. And Isaac, therefore, represents the Jewish Mesorah, the Jewish tradition handed down from parent to child, from generation to generation. And Jews throughout Jewish history have been called upon to give up their lives for God. I mean, this was true in all of the wars that we fought, in the auto de fes, in the times of persecution and crusades, and kiss the cross or die, and even to go to Auschwitz singing Anima Amin. And the Jews who have given up their lives for God have done it not because they heard God's command, but because they heard the voice of their tradition. They heard the voice of their parents and grandparents and great-grandparents. So Isaac is the continuer. Isaac represents Jewish tradition. Isaac represents the commitment unto death which every Jew receives from his forebears and proudly bears with dignity, with grace, and with faith. Shabbat Shalom.